We adore you, Christ, and we bless you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world. This is the hymn that today gushes forth from the hearts of the sons of God that rises up from this earth, to unite itself to the hymn of the angels and saints of heaven. Here is the holy cross that today the Mother Church raises up, as a sign of victory of Christ over the world and over sin. To all of you today, I say, embrace this cross, not as a symbol of defeat, but as a symbol of victory of Christ and his sons. Love the cross, carry it with pride. Manifest your belonging to Christ. The cross is a symbol of light, of victory, of liberation, of resurrection, of eternal life. The cross of Christ is undoubtedly a symbol of religious importance, because in Christ the Father has made his new covenant with this humanity. The cross is also a symbol of social, civil, and cultural identity of entire peoples and nations, that by entrusting themselves to the cross of Christ have won the oppressor, have won those who wanted to subjugate and destroy Christ, Christians, and the whole of Christendom. Today, this church raises the cross of Christ. Exalts the cross on which Jesus is. Proud, holy, and victorious. Admire his face, not the face of one who is defeated, but the humble but proud face of one who wins, not of one who surrenders before the world, but of one who offers himself in order to win and make win, those who entrust themselves to him, those who place their hope in him, not of one who is crowned with the thorns of this world, but of one who is girded on his head with the crown of glory, the sign of resurrection, of ascension to heaven, of the one who has opened the gates of paradise, so that all may live the kingdom promised by the Father, who in Jerusalem, now is. Here the Father has placed his tent, here the presence of the Father is alive, here is the Father, who with his eye, all sees and accompanies his sons, with his gaze of love and closeness, a watchful eye, to protect his sons. A gaze that is also a warning, for all his enemies, for all those who challenge Christ and Christianity. Today, every enemy of God flees at the sight of the Holy Cross. Today, the lukewarm may be warmed by the warmth of the cross, Trinitarian and victorious of Christ. So as not to be overwhelmed by the deception of iniquity and thus lose eternal life. The eye of the Father scrutinizes all and sees all, in his infinite mercy and infallible justice. And here is the dove of the Holy Spirit, united and nestled between the Father and Son, that radiates light, 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 that light that is life. Here are the five rays of light that have illuminated and continue to illuminate the path of the sons of God. Those five rays that are balm for the sons of this Mother Earth, that are pure love, that heals the five wounds that Jesus suffered and offered for love on the wood of the cross. Sanctify yourselves, honor and glorify with your life the eternal sacrifice of the Son of God. Be, to make all be in Christ and Mary. Be those who have died to the world and to sin, live in Christ so that every heart may consist in the love of Christ. So that peace in Christ may be stable on this earth, so that with sincerity of heart many may receive the truth, proclaimed in the four Gospels, so that everyone may live the true joy, that is only in Christ and in Mary. Today, the promises of the one and triune God are fulfilled. All things pass, but his words will not pass. Today, the heavens and earth opens, to give the world a new lymph, made of the holy fragrance of the living bread, new, descended from heaven, renewed in this new covenant, that here the Father has re-established, so that may be born in the hearts of all, the living will to serve Christ and his church, to serve Mary and her holy people, to serve the church, to serve the Father. Here is the rainbow of God, that marks the renewal of the new covenant between the Father and his sons. Here is the circle of the new covenant, founded on charity and obedience, formed in the holy union of humility and of purity, in order to win with disarming simplicity, giving that sweet honey, that is balm and fortitude in the Spirit, and to remain faithful to the call of he who is, that gives life and gives it eternally. Here is this cross, sign of rebirth and rematch on sin and on all those who have sinned. Here is the Trinitarian cross of light, of resurrection, that will furrow again the hearts to lead them on the right path, that this ark crosses, Mary metaphysical ark, that leads all to the heart of the Father. Climb on this ark, to pass to this shore and so, avoid drifting. Take the pure and holy hands of Mary, Ark of the New and Renewed Covenant, and she will lead you to the heart of the Father, where you can hear the heartbeat of life. Here the Father with Mary has refounded the foundations of Christian values, cementing them in the heart of those who come here to find mercy and peace, to find the All. Where the All had gone astray and was lost. Here is the Rock, Christ Rock, victorious and glorious. Invoke the name of Jesus, invoke the name of Mary. In the name of Jesus and in the name of Mary there is salvation, rest and shelter from every storm and every gale, that will soon overwhelm this humanity, once again arid and again lost, because humanity has voluntarily lost the way, has voluntarily distanced itself from the only truth that saves and voluntarily no longer lives to conquer eternal life. Here's the infinite mercy of the Father, who in this land of love, once again manifests itself to be fulfilled in totality, the last call of the love of the Father for his sons. Here the Father has fulfilled the promises of the Son. Here everything is fulfilled. Here is the New Jerusalem. God's kingdom on earth. Here is the holy mountain of God where one contemplates God in spirit and truth. Here is the land of love where God dwells with his sons. Here is the land of the infinite mercy of God where the Almighty Father yearns to embrace every son, who contrite and repentant wishes to receive his embrace of Father, to be cleansed and saved. Come all of you who want to be reconciled with the good and holy Father. The Father awaits you in this sanctuary dedicated to divine mercy. The Father welcomes you to console your contrite hearts and give everyone his embrace of love, from heart to heart, from father to son. Here are the symbols that today in this solemn feast, this church manifests, the victorious Trinitarian cross of the Son of God, united to the infinite mercy of the Father, who embraces the Son. In the sacrifice of the cross of the sons are reconciled with the Father to relive his commandments, absolutes, and understand them and manifest them in the one love that saves, which is Christ, united to Mary. Who loves Christ, loves the Father, who loves Mary, loves the Son and in the only begotten Holy Spirit love, they love the brothers, they love the sisters. Hear that again God wins the world, with the disarming weapons of the faith, of hope and charity, of prudence, temperance, fortitude and justice, of obedience, of purity and humility. The cornerstone virtues of Christian faith, that in this Mother Church are the center of the path of every Son of God. This is our faith, Christian and universal. And these are the symbols of our faith, that today, we honor to manifest. Alive is my gratitude, for all of you faithful. And for your delegates, who have wanted to donate these symbols to the Mother Church. Alive is my gratitude, for all those who contribute every day, to spiritual and material needs of the Church. Now, we are Church. And after a long crossing in the desert of this world that lasted precisely 40 years, from 1975, the year of the opening of the little cradle of the baby Jesus, to 2015, the year of the earthly foundation of the Church. And after further years of continuous trials and adversities, now we want to manifest more and more to the world of goodwill, our being Church, Church of Christ, Church of the Father, to you faithful and to you, beloved young people, today I say, manifest by your example, your being Church, assembly of believers in Christ, never let yourselves be overcome by the feeling of discouragement or discouragement that grips this world. Be holy, be humble, be pure, be obedient to the Father's will. Be. And following the example of the young maiden of God, who gave life and offered her life to make this Church rise. Say every day, uniting yourselves to her motherly heart, I love you Jesus, I love you so much, I entrust myself to you, do of me what pleases you, may your will be done. Manifest your faith with righteousness and pride, as with pride this Jesus looks at you, with his holy and victorious face, in communion of heart, soul and spirit with he who became living bread, for love of the Father. Manifest today and always your love and your gratitude to the Father who honored us, by calling us to make everyone live this mystery of love. Love this good Father, holy, merciful, just, alive, 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 who has a beating heart that beats for his sons, for his church. Love this church, your church, always support it, live it with holiness, be flawless in everything and for everything, so that no stain may tarnish this church. So that the world may see and believe that the words revealed by the Most Holy Mary to Maria Giuseppina Norcia in the prayer revealed in honor of the Most Holy Cross, today are fulfilled. Behold the new kingdom. Behold the new Jerusalem. Behold the cross of light that overcomes the world. Behold the one and triune Jesus, who descended here to win, not to succumb, and to make all his sons and all those who belong to him win. And so be it.